At the beginning of the episode, a man named Aditya Singh narrates his daily life as a doctor. He and his wife Rani live a happy and simple life together, until one day at work, a woman with a strange disease visits the doctor. Her pinky finger moves aggressively as a symptom of the disease. A new kind of virus named H5G9 is discovered in her blood. The very next day, Aditya goes to work to see several such cases. The government declares the outbreak as an emergency, claiming that the H5G9 virus is the deadliest virus of all time. Experts predict the number of infected people will reach higher than it did during the Black Plague. Chaos ensues in the world as shops, factories, and hospitals start closing. One day, the doctor wakes up to his wife coughing on the floor. She too has gotten the virus. He rushes her to the hospital through the crowd of people, all facing the same situation. While at the hospital, Aditya is called by a nurse who seems to be in shock. The maternity ward is full of newborn babies who all have features of different animals. The word soon gets out as every baby in the world is born as a human and animal hybrid. People start to hate the babies, saying that they are the ones who caused the virus outbreak. Others believe that the virus caused such babies to be born, but no one knows for sure how they came into existence. It's like the chicken and the egg, except it's what came first, the deadly virus or the mutant animal babies. While the whole world trembles in fear of the virus, one father moves into the wilderness with his child for protection. His son, Gus, born as a human-deer hybrid, is one of the first ever hybrid babies. The man reaches an abandoned house in the middle of the woods and reforms it to make it his own. Days pass as he takes care of Gus and reconstructs the house, making it suitable for them both to live. He even builds a fence around the area to protect him and Gus. He writes books for Gus to read, but doesn't teach him much about the outside world. Gus grows up quickly and starts calling his father Pubba. Gus soon turns 4 years old, still unknown to the world outside the fence. Pubba teaches his kid to duck if he hears a growl, run if he hears a voice, and hide if he ever sees a human. A montage of the father and son playing in the snow, fishing, reading books, and cooking together is shown. One day, while they are out, an airplane passes overhead. Pubba shuts Gus's ears and tells him it is just a big bird. The plane is distributing pamphlets that advertise a safe place for hybrids called the preserves. He throws the papers away, not wanting to take the kid into the world. On one of Gus's birthdays, he gives him a stuffed toy, which Gus brings everywhere with him. The stuffed toy is a dog, and Gus names it Dog. This kid has a bright future ahead of him. One day, while Gus reads a book in the jungle, he sees a deer nearby. He runs to his father to tell him that he saw his mother. Pubba tells him that his mother was a human named Birdie, and she is no more. He also claims that there are bad people outside the fence who harm kids like him, so he should never cross the fence. One night, Pubba brings out a box with a picture and stuff from his old life. He buries the box in the woods, letting go of his past completely. On Gus's 10th birthday, Pubba gives him a slingshot, which the boy loves a lot. While playing with it, he ends up outside the fence. Before anyone can see him, Pubba grabs the kid and rushes him back to the house. He scolds him for putting his life in danger, making little Gus cry. Later that day, a man comes near the fence, calling for his sister. Gus threatens the man to go away, claiming that his sister isn't there, but before leaving, he gets a glimpse of Gus hiding in the back. The man marks the fence as an area that has hybrid humans, revealing that he is actually a hybrid child hunter. Pubba freaks out and makes Gus hide. He goes out to fight the man and doesn't return for the whole night. A scared Gus stays in the dark for the night and comes outside when the sun rises. Just then, Pubba returns with injuries all over himself. Gus helps his father and brings him to a bed, but Pubba knows that he has gotten the virus. Since hybrid humans are immune to it, he isn't worried about Gus getting the virus, but Pubba has limited time now. He teaches Gus some basic survival skills and asks him to get eggs from the ducks for breakfast. When Gus returns with them, Pubba is dead on a seat, holding a key. Gus takes the key and cries quietly, mourning his father's death. After that day, he starts living on his own and manages to do it to some extent. He makes animal figures from dried grass and talks to them to feel less isolated. Wow, I've been doing the same thing for this past year. After 10 winters pass, the boy has learned to do almost everything he needs to stay alive, but some days are more difficult than others. One day, the isolation gets the best of him, making him burn his animal figures during broad daylight. The smoke from the fire attracts the men, who hunt creatures like him. Later that same day, Gus notices a heart drawn on the forest's map, and goes to look for it. It is the place where Pubba had buried the box with his wife's picture in it. Gus opens the box with the key Pubba had with him when he died. Gus then looks at his mother's face for the first time and sees the picture has Colorado written at the bottom. With every intention of finding his mom, the little boy decides to go to Colorado. He packs everything he needs and takes a map of the US with him. After the preparation, the naive kid makes his way to the fence. He sees a candy lying on the ground and eats it, but soon finds out it is a trap. Two hybrid hunters catch the boy and are surprised to see he can talk. They know Gus is very valuable, so instead of shooting him, they decide to hold him for ransom. Just then, a man shoots one of the hunters dead and chases the other one away. Gus runs back to his home and hides, but he is followed by the man who saved him. He finds Gus and is surprised to see he has been living alone this whole time. At first, Gus seems afraid of him and hits him with his slingshot several times, but soon realizes he isn't a bad person. The man reveals that he was thinking about turning Gus in to the officials, who use hybrid babies for experiments, but decided against it when he saw Gus is more human than a deer. The man calls Gus Sweet Tooth and asks him to stay inside the fence for his own safety before leaving. After the man is gone, Gus thinks about him for a while and suddenly decides to break all of his father's rules at once. He tracks the man with his amazing ability to smell and finds him near a cliff. The first episode ends as Gus calls the man Big Man and asks him to take him to Colorado. In the second episode, we are introduced to a woman named Amy, who used to be a therapist before the virus outbreak. She stayed in her office for a few years after the outbreak, going out only when she had to, until one day when she decides to step outside for the first time in years. Outside, everything is abandoned and the streets are deserted. Suddenly, she notices a herd of elephants walking in the street towards her. Amy, who is fed up with her tedious everyday routine, feels alive for the first time in years. She visits a zoo nearby and finally finds what makes her happy. She starts taking care of the animals. Meanwhile, Gus follows Big Man, even after being told to go back to his house repeatedly. The man tries to get rid of the boy several times, but is unsuccessful. At night, he stops to rest and eats canned food. Gus watches him from behind the tree, knowing that he can see him. The man gives Gus some food and sleeps. While he is asleep, Gus sees his bag is full of canned food. He eats all of them, including the man's medicine, which he desperately needs. When the man wakes up the following day, he is furious at the kid and asks him to go back immediately. Gus says that he can help the man collect more food using his nose. He then shows the man a visitor's center nearby. The man makes him go inside the house to steal the food while he stays outside to keep guard. Gus reluctantly enters and is fascinated to see different modern things, but then he notices a deer's head mounted on the wall and retreats, falling into a trap. A little boy finds him there and calls his parents. The three watch Gus in awe as he tells them to leave his head alone. In the following scene, we see the family of three treating the man and Gus to a meal. They wear masks to be safe from them, just in case they have the virus. It turns out the family had run away from the city when the outbreak occurred and has never met another person since. The man tells them that the virus is still out there and some people have it, but it is not as widespread as it was before because people live isolated lives. The kid named Rusty tries to touch Gus's horns, but is stopped by his mother. Gus then shows them his mother's picture and asks them if they know her. The mother of the family says that she doesn't. She allows him and Rusty to play together after confirming that Gus doesn't bite. The boys soon become friends, and the mother delightedly watches them play. At the same time, the father talks to Big Man and recognizes him as a famous football player, Tommy Jeppard. Tommy confirms he used to be an athlete before the viral outbreak. When asked what he wants from the family, Tommy replies that he only wants some food and a place to stay for the night. They agree to help him and Gus. Somewhere else, the doctor we saw at the beginning of the series, Aditya Singh, still lives with his wife, Rani. Rani has been suffering from the sickness since its outbreak, but is living off medicine that a colleague of Aditya makes. They still live in their old home, but away from most people, getting out only when they have to. We see the couple playing Scrabble and missing the fact that there is no internet. Just then, Rani's finger starts to move involuntarily, suggesting that the effect of the medicine is wearing off. The doctor gives her another dose, leaving only one dose left. Later that day, he goes to his doctor friend who manufactures the medicine. There, Aditya gets to know that she is in the last stage of cancer and cannot continue to work anymore. She has been working actively to find a cure to the virus throughout the years and doesn't want her work to go to waste. The doctor gives Aditya her notes, which also has the procedure to make Rani's medicines. She sees off Aditya after a final goodbye, telling him to please continue the research. Aditya comes back home with the notes and doesn't seem too happy about being handed the work. Rani thinks it is great because Aditya himself can save her now. But then she looks into the doctor's notes and is shocked. Aditya claims that his colleague's gruesome work goes against everything he believes in. Back at the visitor's center, Tommy and Rusty's mother have a chat about Tommy's wrongdoings. She calls him out for killing people, and Tommy claims he did it for survival. We do not know what they are talking about just yet. Tommy asks the mother to keep Gus with her family, but she doesn't reply. Later, the mother puts Gus and Rusty to sleep together. Gus is saddened to see Rusty's mother taking care of him and feels a little jealous. The mother looks at Birdie's picture again and recognizes the background as red rocks. At night, Gus cannot fall asleep and goes downstairs to find Tommy about to walk out of the house with all of his stuff. As they talk, some hybrid hunters approach the house, alerting the two. Soon, the family wakes up as well and finds out the people are looking for Gus. They are willing to kill everyone to get the little boy. Tommy sees a bear trap mounted on the wall and attacks the hunters with it. He kills most of them, but their leader manages to get to Gus. He is about to shoot him, but stops when a deer suddenly appears behind the little boy. Distracted by the deer, he doesn't notice Tommy behind and is killed by him. It is now the following day. The family apologizes to Tommy because they cannot keep Gus. They like the kid, but the family's safety is their top priority. At last, Gus and Tommy leave for the nearest town after saying their goodbyes. In the following scene, we see the former therapist, Amy, working in her zoo. Suddenly, she hears a noise outside and goes to check it. A surprised Amy finds a little human and pig hybrid baby outside at the entrance. The episode ends as Tommy and Gus go on a journey that will lead them to paths beyond their imagination. All the characters are destined to meet and potentially change the course of the world.